हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंडियन जुडिशियल सर्विस। टुडेज वी आर डिस्कस हेयर क्वेश्चन नंबर 281 to 300। दिस इज द पार्ट 16 ऑफ टॉप 400 एमसीक्यू ऑफ कोड ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर। नाउ कम टू पॉइंट हेयर, क्वेश्चन नंबर 281। द हेयरिंग ऑन सेंटेंस, सो हेयर इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड इज हेयरिंग ऑन सेंटेंस बाय अ मजिस्ट्रेट इज रिक्वायर ऑन कन्विक्शन। ऑप्शन ए हेयर इन समन ट्रायल द केस अंडर सेक्शन 255 सबसेक्शन 2। ऑप्शन बी हेयर इन वारंट ट्रायल केस अंडर सेक्शन 248 सबसेक्शन 2 ऑफ सीआरपीसी। ऑप्शन सी बोथ ए एंड बी। ऑप्शन डी ओनली बी नॉट ए। सो आंसर इज हेयर ऑप्शन सी। इट इज क्लियर दैट द हेयरिंग ऑन सेंटेंस इट दिस प्रोसेस इज आफ्टर द कन्विक्शन ऑफ द एक्यूज। सो इन समन केस इट इज अवेलेबल इन सेक्शन 255 सबसेक्शन 2 एंड इन वारंट केस इट इज अवेलेबल इन 248 सबसेक्शन 2। सो इन दिस सेक्शंस These sections are deal with the magistrate cell after hearing the accused on the question of sentence, the pass a sentence upon according to the law. So this process is after the conviction of the accused, when the accused is convict, and after that the hearing on the basis of sentence. So what amount of sentence is given to the accused? Now question number 282. The under section 248 subsection 2, the conviction and sentence can be passed on same day. Option B, conviction and sentence cannot be passed on same day. Option C, conviction and sentence pass on same day. Same day shall be valid unless the occasion failure of justice. Option D here, both A and C. So in this question, answer is here option C. Conviction and sentence passed on same day unless the occasion failure of justice. So now question number 283. In summon case, the institute on a complaint, the accused have been a summoned is liable to be acquitted under section 256 of CRPC. Option A here, on account of death of the complainant, on account of non-appearance of complainant. Option C, both A and B. Option D, only B, not A. So in this question, answer is here option C, both A and B, and on the account of death of complainant, and option B here, on the account of non-appearance of the complainant. So according to section 256 subsection 1, provided that the non-appearance of complainant and 256 subsection 2 is provided deal with the provision of death of complainant. Some important point is also there. If these things are happen, the accused is acquittal according to section 256. The result of these things is acquittal. But in warrant case, according to section 249, the accused is only discharged. So, in summon case, according to section, non-appearance of the complainant. So the accused is acquittal. In warrant case, non-appearance of the complainant, here is the accused is discharged, not acquittal. According to question number 284, in a summon trial, the case instituted on a complaint wherein summon have been issued to the accused, the non-appearance and death of complainant shall be entailed. Option A here, discharge of accused. First important point here, discharge of accused. Option B here, acquittal of accused. Option C, either discharge or acquittal, depending on the fact and circumstance of the case. Option D here, option A and C above. So it is clear here, in summon case on the case institute on complaint, so accused, non-appearance of the complainant, the accused is acquittal here. Option B is correct here, according to section 256. Now question number 285, the withdrawal of complaint under section 256 of CRPC, the result is option A, acquittal of the accused in case where discharge has already been framed. Option B, discharge of accused in case where a discharge has not yet been framed. Option C, acquittal of accused irrespective of whether the charge has been framed option or not. Option D here, either A or B. So it is clear here, option C is correct here. In withdrawal of complaint under section 257, the acquittal of accused irrespective of whether the charge has frame or there is no matter whether charge is framed or not. The withdrawal of the complaint under section 256, the accused is acquittal. There is no the relevancy of the charge is frame or not. Now question number 286, the compounding of offense under section 320. So it is clear here, the 320 deal with the compounding of offense. There is a list of offense which are compounding of CRPC, result in acquittal of the accused under all circumstances. Option B, acquittal of accused only where a charge has already been framed. Option C, charge of the accused where the charge has not yet been framed. Option D here, B and or C. So in this question, answer is here option A, the compounding of offense under section 320 of CRPC result in acquittal of the accused under all circumstances. Now question number 287, the proceeding under section 258 of CRPC can be stopped in summon case institute upon complaint. So first important, summon case and institute upon complaint. In summon case institute otherwise means suo motu or any other information by person, otherwise than upon the complaint. Option C, in warrant case institute upon a complaint. Option D, in warrant case institute otherwise than upon a complaint. So answer of this question is here, in summon case institute otherwise upon the complaint. Now question number 288, the stoppage of proceeding under section 258 of CRPC has the effect of acquittal under all circumstances. Option B here, acquittal where the evidence of the principal witness has been recorded. Option C, discharge in all other case where the evidence of principal witness has not been recorded. Option C, D here, only B and C. So it is clear here, these two point B and C are affected here. So acquittal where the evidence of principal witness has been recorded, and option C, if the principal witness evidence of principal witness is recorded, the accused is here acquittal according to section stoppage of the proceeding under section 258, and option C here discharge, in which case all other cases and where the evidence of principal witness has not been recorded. if the evidence of principal witness is recorded according to section 258, the accused is acquittal when the proceeding is stopped. But if the recording of the principal witness, evidence of the principal witness is not recorded and the proceeding is stopped by the magistrate, so the result is discharge and the accused getting the benefit. Now question number 289. The magistrate has the power under section 259 of CRPC to convert the summon trial case into a warrant trial case, the relating to any offense irrespective of punishment prescribed. Option B here, relating to an offense punishable for punishable for exceeding term 6 months here. Option C here, relating to an offense punishable for term exceeding 1 year. Option D here, relating to an offense punishable for term exceeding 2 year. So according to section 259, the magistrate convert the summon case into a warrant case, but there is a restriction. If the punishment of such offense is less than 6 months, the magistrate cannot convert the summon case into warrant case. So there is a limitation of 6 months. There must be an offense punishable with 6 months. So answer is here option B. Now question number 290. Under section 260 of CRPC, which of the following offense cannot be tried summarily? So offense punishable with the imprisonment exceeding 3 months, offense punishable with the imprisonment exceeding 6 months, offense punishable with imprisonment exceeding 1 year. Option D here, offense punishable with imprisonment exceeding 2 year. So it is clear here option D, the offense punishable with imprisonment exceeding 2 year is not tried summarily. According, this is the negative sections, and the provision of 260 provided that the magistrate cannot be tried summarily if the offense is punishable with the life imprisonment, capital punishment, or offense punishable with exceeding two year. So answer is here, the magistrate can try summarily only those offense which are punishable less than 2 year. So answer is here option D. Now question number 291. Under section 311 of CRPC, the witness can be called on the motion of the prosecution, on the motion of defense, on its own motion by court, all of the above. So it is clear here section 311, the witness can be called by the prosecution, defense, and the own motion by the court. So answer is here all of the above. Now question number 292. The power recall any witness under section 311 of CRPC can be exercised even after the evidence of both side is closed, after the evidence of prosecution is closed, but before the evidence of defense is closed. Option C here, before the evidence of prosecution is closed, and if the witness is to be called on the motion of the prosecution. Option D here, after the evidence of prosecution is closed, so here prosecution order is closed, if the witness is called on the motion of the defense. So in this question, the power to recall any witness under section 311 of CRPC can be exercised only even after the evidence of both side is closed. So answer option A is correct here. Now question number 293. The power under section 311 of CRPC can be exercised to recall any witness already examined. option B here. To summon any witness and who has cited a witness but not produced or examined before the evidence is closed. It is correct here. Option C here. The summon any witness who has not been cited as witness. It is also available here. So in this question, I again read here question. The power under section 311 can be exercised. So according to 311 of section, the provided the recall of the witness. So recall of any witness already examined. So it is available according to section 311. To summon any witness who has cited but not produced, examined before the evidence is closed, and it is cited but not produced for examination. And option C here, the summon to any witness who has not been cited as witness. So all these correct. So option D is correct in this question. Now question number 294. Under section 313 of CRPC, the statement of accused. So option A has to be recorded on oath. So first of all, important point is what thing is available in section 313. This is very important section here. Section 313 provide the power to examine the accused person. So according to section 313 subsection 1, the explain that the any circumstance appear in the evidence against him. So the purpose of the enabling the accused. So what thing is available, why this section is available in CRPC? It's only available for the purpose of enabling the accused person personally explain the circumstance appear in the evidence against him. So in accused explain personally the circumstance appear in the evidence against him. So this is the defense. This provision provides the defense to the accused in the evidence against him. So this is provided in section 313 subsection 1. And subsection 1 is provided that the court may at any stage without previous warning ask the question to the accused. So this is important point here, subsection 1a, the without previous, whenever the examination of witness according to section 164 by the magistrate, but and the magistrate warn the accused this the questions and the answers of your question is used against you, but here magistrate is not warned without giving warning to accused. So there is no warning point here to the accused, and the oath is must there according to the same section 164. The oath is not there. So in this question, in this section, no oath according to subsection 2 of section 313. No oath. No oath shall be administered. So no oath is available in the section subsection 2 of section 313. answer of this question here, the has been recorded on oath has been without oath. So option B is correct. There is no provision of oath. Now question number 296. Answer given by the accused to the question put him while recording the statement under section 313 of CRPC can be taken the consideration for option A, the judge innocence to the accused, option B, judge the guilty the accused, option C, judge innocence or guilty of the accused, option D, neither for judging the innocence nor the guilty of the accused. It clear here, option C, judge the innocence or guilty of the accused. So again I read here question, answer to given the question, so answer given by the accused to the question put him while recording the statement according to section 313 the CRPC can be taken into consideration for judging to innocence or guilt of the accused. Now question number 297, each material circumstance appear in evidence against the accused must be put to accused specifically, distinctly and separately in which context the proposition are option A here, option 1 here, not A, the failure to put the material evidence to failure to put material evidence to the accused always vitiate the trial. No, this is wrong here. Option B, failure to put the material evidence amount to serious irregularity which cannot be cured and vitiate the trial if it has prejudicated the accused. Yes, it is correct here. Option third here, the failure to put the material evidence is not considered or to service and is curable if the in fact no failure of justice has occasioned to the accused. So yes, it is also correct here. Now which of the following is correct? First and second, no, first is wrong here, second is correct. So option B here, first and third, no, first wrong, third is correct. Option C, first, second, third are correct, no. Option D, second and third, yes, second and third are correct. So answer is here, option D. Question number 298, the offense can be compounded. So which section of provided? Section 320. Provide that 320 deal with the compounding of offenses. Under section 320 of CRPC, by the legal guardian of option A, the person under the age of 18. So here under the age, below the age of 18. Option B, the person who is idiot. Option C, person who is lunatic. So answer is here, option D, all of the above. Now question 299, if the person who is competent to compound is dead, so the person who is competent to compound is dead, the compounding cannot be done, can be done by the legal representative of deceased without permission. This is important here, without permission of court. Option C, can be done by LR, legal representative of deceased, only with the permission of court. Yes, this is the correct option here, only with the permission, can be allowed by the legal representative only when the court permit him. So answer is here, option C. Final question of this video, question number 300. Under section 321 of CRPC, द प्रोसिक्यूशन कैन बी विड्रॉन इन समन केस विदाउट कंसेंट ऑफ द कोर्ट. ऑप्शन बी द प्रोसिक्यूशन कैन बी विड्रॉन इन द इन अ वारंट केस विदाउट कंसेंट ऑफ द कोर्ट. ऑप्शन सी इन एनी टाइप ऑफ केस बट ओनली विद द कंसेंट ऑफ कोर्ट. ऑप्शन डी बोथ ए एंड बी. सो आंसर इज हियर ऑप्शन सी. एंड सेक्शन 321 डील विद द विड्रॉवल ऑफ द केस. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेक्शन. इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस दिस सेक्शन. सो इन दिस सेक्शन प्रोवाइड दैट द एनी टाइप ऑफ केस बट ओनली एनी टाइप ऑफ केस इज विड्रॉल बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट और द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट थ्रू देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव और प्रोसिक्यूशन ऑफिसर्स बट ओनली इन द कंडीशन ऑफ कंसेंट ऑफ कोर्ट. सो ओनली विद द कंसेंट ऑफ कोर्ट. सो आंसर इज हियर ऑप्शन सी. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज क्लिक ऑन लाइक बटन एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल एंड क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन बटन फॉर फर्दर नोटिफिकेशन. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.